I've always known that I wanted to be a doctor, and I was looking for colleges that had a really strong science program.
I knew that I wanted to go into the sciences. I really loved biology, just the way the body works.
I always knew I loved math, so the next step was to figure out what else I would be interested in.
Penn State is one of the top research universities in the country. Whatever project I want to do, we can do it here. This is basically as good as it gets.
What color means for?
Doing science means that I can find out things before anyone ever finds out. I love research because it's like being an explorer.
Penn State has a lot of opportunities, and so you don't have to know exactly what you want to do.
Penn State is so big and offers so many programs. I mean, we have everything from forensics to marine biology.
Which avenue in the sciences I wanted to go, I was a little iffy on that.
So students have the opportunity to take different courses in areas they might be interested in and find out whether it's something that they like.
The ones that I have are just a small substitute.
Part of my job is to be a talent scout. And so find out what a particular student is most interested in and most talented in.
And it travels.
When you walk onto campus for the first time, that can seem daunting. But within that large university, there are lots of small communities. And if you look, you're almost certain to find one that matches you perfectly.
A university this large means we have wonderful resources. We've got great teaching labs, we've got top-of-the-line facilities, and we've got some of the best researchers in the world.
Start with personal materials.
Which means that students are learning from the experts in their field.
The professors in Penn State Science are very enthusiastic, encouraging. They teach you, they nurture you.
A gradient.
They share their passion with the students.
This is a low pressure, right?
We make discoveries in the lab every day and nobody else in the entire world knows. And that's really cool. Some of the concerns of students is that they don't have prior lab experience, but that's fine.
I think we can do this with a real-time PCR.
The professors here know that it is a teaching institution.
Yeah, this looks a lot better.
Yeah.
And they want to get students involved. In my freshman year, it was very easy to get a job in one of the professor's labs. I basically emailed him, explained why I was interested in research, and I've been in his lab since then.
Moving to a big campus could be really tough, and so they've got somewhere that they can belong. Labs are like mini families.
I think there's got to be some kind of incompatibility. I try to get the undergraduates into the group early on in their career.
Yeah. So you guys are talking about, yeah.
Once they develop fundamental skills, there's really no limit to what they can contribute.
I don't expect them to have a research experience.
Yeah, it's just interesting that we're not seeing.
But you should probably dilute it like 1,000-fold or something.
They're here to learn and become fully functional, independent researchers by the time they leave.
Joining a research lab, you not only contribute to whatever science they're doing, but also you develop the mindset of a scientist, how to think critically, ask questions, find ways to solve problems if your experiments aren't working out. And you have the chance to dabble in a little bit before you start to narrow down your interests.
We're studying the decline of bumblebees in North Carolina.
You grab it from one leg.
And why don't you just put all of the males into where the queens are?
People overlook that bumblebees are needed for a lot of vegetation growth. They're pollinators. Using geospatial programs, we can analyze and map this decline and see the distribution of these species.
I look at the genetic basis for skeletal development in embryonic mammals. We basically take a mouse gene, we mutate it, and from what happens to these mice, we determine the normal function of the gene.
You can stay in one research program and get really great depth, or you can go and visit different research programs and spend a semester in each.
You can try a bunch of different things and see what really is a good match for you.
As a scientist, it is very important not only to do the research, but to be able to communicate it effectively.
from this research that I'm doing, there's the opportunity to get published.
Most of the undergraduates that go through the lab do end up as authors on peer-reviewed publications.
Several friends have published review articles, their experiments and their studies in major scientific journals.
The undergraduates typically present their research in their junior and senior year through poster presentations.
Yeah.
Study abroad programs are a really amazing opportunity. Seeing a different culture in a different country can really change a student's perspective on life and on careers.
I did a 2-week mission trip to Ecuador with Hershey Medical Center, and they provided pro bono heart surgeries for Ecuadorian children there. It was very interesting to see what medicine in another country was like.
I did an internship in Germany doing physics research. I studied the magnetic properties of materials. It was a lot of fun to live there, but also it was great to see how science is done abroad. It was an amazing opportunity.
It's really the people that are the foundation to doing great research.
Penn State is a great community. It's great to see what people are doing.
There's great staff supporting, there's great instructors. We're able to attract really good students.
Every faculty member here wants every student to succeed. When someone has never done research before, tries it, decides they love it, and then goes on to the next step. That's just really fun.
It's a very positive atmosphere amongst all the people and all these resources. And I think that's why it's a great place.
Penn State, they just offer you so much.
Penn State is definitely a great place for you to find what your passions are.